Hey guys.
Ooh, this is cricket. So today, I went to work earlier today, and then, it was Halloween, so you know, we were supposed to go and have trick-or-treating with the kids, but it was supposed to rain. Never rained. And so we did like little trick-or-treating activities inside the school. And I wish we would have went trick-or-treating, but since I do take some of the kids home, I took them to different houses as I was taking them home. And I let them get out and get some candy from the people that were participating in giving candy out to kids. So that was fun. And I taxed them, which means I took some of their candy for stopping at those houses. Period, poo. I had my mouth watering and waiting for after dinner I was going to eat that candy. I had Kit Kats, Reese's, Snickers, Skittles, Now and Later, Starburst. Like, and guess what I did? Left it on the bus. I left it on the bus. I've been tempted to go and drive by the school and pick it up from the bus, but that's like 20 minutes, 25 minutes. I don't wanna, and it's almost 11, I think. Is it? Yeah, it's 11:43. Like, hopefully when the kids get picked up in the morning, they don't take my candy, cause I'm gonna be real upset. I'm gonna be upset. Okay, girl. About an hour ago, I uploaded my last House of Horrors video. I was inspired by Poison Ivy from Batman. And right now, I was folding my clothes up, but I got tired. And right now, I'm just watching one of my favorite YouTubers, Welp on a Whim. His video, I think he got lost in Spain. I'm not sure. It was okay. I had a little fun. It was okay. But now it's time for Thanksgiving and Black Friday. I'm gonna go this weekend and get me some more socks and underwear and maybe go thrifting, maybe. I don't know. But I know I need me some more socks. Cause baby, that dryer is eating my socks up. Okay. And I also need to go on Monday and get a new tire sensor for my rear right tire. I've been needing one for some time now, so I'll go get one this weekend. I hate spending money. Anyway, best to go grocery shopping and go to Walmart. I think I'm gonna go to Walmart today. Sorry, I'm putting my shoe on. I'll just do that. So yeah, I need some new Vans. I woke up around like 9 o'clock, 9:30. It was the band. So I live by a high school, like a few miles away. And they were just outside, I guess, at their football field, making a bunch of noise. Like, sis, stop, what are you doing? So I could not fall back asleep, so got up, started getting dressed. Besides work, I want to go to a haunted house. I know yesterday was Halloween, but the haunted houses are still open for at least another week. So I would like to go before they close for the rest of the time being. until next year. So hopefully I get to go. I really want to go. Where's my concealer? I'm trying to get ready so I can get out the house. I'm going to do my best to not buy any makeup because today was payday, so. I gotta conserve my money, my funds. Where's my... If you guys know of any like stores that have like little cabinet things that you could put miscellaneous items in, I need a new cabinet for my makeup. This is for the birds. I cannot take this anymore. So you guys, I don't know which jacket I'm gonna wear. I don't know if I wanna go with the jean jacket or with my leather jacket. I don't wanna do a hoodie. Or should I go with this jacket? I got this from H&M. I think it was a Christmas gift. So I don't know. I had this one when I was in college, and I got it from Goodwill. I don't know, because this is not the, like, I go with the sleeves rolled up. Like, how does, I think it looks great. Let's see. Because I'm not dolled up today. And this jean jacket, it's really cold outside. And this, I mean, leather jacket does not... Don't mind this, because my room is junky. I could go with this. I think I might go with the leather jacket. I might go with the leather jacket, you guys. I don't really know how well this jacket is gonna do. And I got these overalls from Forever 21. I wanna go get some more for overalls, but I'ma wait till I go thrifting to see if I can find any for the low, okay? Cause these were like $30, but I had got a coupon, so it was like 20 something. I don't know how I feel about this. I want to be warm. But I want to be comfortable. But I want to look good. See, that's why I hate getting dressed. That's why I need more options. That's why I got to go thrifting. Because I hate trying to figure out what I need to wear or what I want to wear. Because I can do that and still look cute. Like, look at that. I look cute. I might go with the jean jacket. I really don't know, bro. And I need to go so I can do what I need to do before I have to get to work. I don't want to wear this one. I definitely don't want to wear this one. Not with this outfit. I'll wear it another time. I also want to get some more camo pants. I love camo. So I'm going to get me some more camo. I think I'm going to go thrifting today or tomorrow. No, I'm going to leave thrifting for tomorrow after I get off work. I think I'm going to go with the jean jacket, you guys. No, I'm not. I'm using a jean jacket. I mean, leather. I'm gonna go with this jacket here. Aren't you guys? I'll see you guys later. Okay. Bye.
I just spent what did I spend? Like 70. I think I left my receipt. I spent $77. Oh no, then here go my receipt. $77.98. Girl, look at that. $77. My girl. Thank you, Jesus. I have the funds to get the food. Because when I tell you the government did my renewal for food stamps, and baby, they guess what they gave me? Guess what they gave your girl? They gave me $16. How am I going to feed myself with $16? You're supposed to be helping me until I can get to where I need to be. Like, $16? You might as well just say, go get a Happy Meal. Go get a Happy Meal, girl. Call us next week.
This is for Rachel, you big, fat, white, nasty, smelling, fat bitch.
Like, what? I'm so over it. You know what? The welfare system in America is trash. You're supposed to be helping people that need a little assistance for the time being until they can get to where they need to be. And sir, man, you're in the middle. I can't turn... Out in the middle of the street. You're supposed to be helping citizens that cannot afford to get their own food all the time. And I'm not ashamed to say sometimes I can't afford it because I got bills and it ain't working out. But thank the Lord that I have the funds today to get what I need to get. And so... I ain't gonna complain. I'm gonna just be grateful, thankful, because I know somebody's not eating at all. So that's our little lesson for today.
Hey guys, welcome back. Welcome back. Got home about what, 2 hours ago? I was out most of the day. One of the girls' soccer teams to their game today. And it's currently 9:31. Today was a long day. I'm waiting for Dana to be ready. So waiting for that. Yesterday I went to the movies to see Harriet with my mom. It was a very good movie. I suggest you all go see it. It has great messages in it through Harriet's life. A few of the messages that I took from the movie: one, don't let other people's fear affect how you view your future. Two, what was number two? Two was know that God will send you somewhere where you think you're supposed to go, but he'll switch it for you to go do something else. So for spoiler, Harriet went back to save her husband after she left. She ran away the first time. Well, the only time. She ran away. After a year, she went back. And she went to go get her husband. But when she got back to the plantation, she found out that her husband had moved on. He thought she had drowned in a river when she jumped off the bridge to save herself from her master trying to get her. he thought she passed away, all that. So only a year after, a few months to a year after her leaving, he married and had a child. Well, the child was on the way. And so when she got back, she was devastated. And so when she returned back north to Philadelphia, this Lady Marie, where she was staying at, and it was like a hostel almost back then. In today's terms, it would probably be mostly considered a hostel. But, you know, in their time, it was just a group home. But the lady that owned it, Marie, was like doing her hair while she was in the tub washing. And she was saying, Harriet was saying how she felt like God sent her back to go save. She went back to go save John. But God used that whole moment to actually save other people. Because after she found out that John, what's the man named John? I think his name was John. After she went back to try to save him, she actually came back to Philadelphia with 9 slaves. So that's what started her, like, being a conductor on the Underground Railroad. And I didn't even know that. I thought Harriet, all this time, I thought Harriet was the one that created the Underground Railroad. But the Underground Railroad was apparently created by a bunch of different abolitionists. And Harriet was just one of the more famous conductors on this railroad. And by what they mean by conductor is she had the most dangerous job as actually taking the slaves from the plantations during the workday. So the slaves would be out on the field and she would come and be in the woods by the field, and she would sing this song. Like, you know the old Negro spirituals, like Let My People Go, like the old Negro spirituals as what slaves would sing to send messages. So if I'm coming to say bye to you, I would sing an old song where the meaning was, I love you and I see you soon. So they would sing these songs to send messages to one another, and the white people wouldn't know. They would just think they were singing. So it was a very good movie. It gave a lot of information as to Harriet's life before and after and during. There's a lot of things I didn't know about Harriet that I found out during the movie. So I'm glad I went to go see it. You guys should go see it. Today was a good day. I was supposed to record my Music Monday video today, but I didn't have enough time because I woke up around 9 o'clock. That was yesterday. I'm getting confused. Anyway, I'll see you guys later. Okay.